I've also set the session on recording, guys. And the topic for today, I hope most of you are aware about the topic. Can I get to know from each one of you what exactly is your understanding in terms of the topic which we are going to cover today? No audio. Is that for everybody? Can you guys hear me? Right, so Santosh can hear me. Dhruv can hear. Shashank is able to hear. Right, so Ashish, you can also hear. Okay, that's great. So in case somebody is not, please restart, go to meeting. I'm just typing for that person. All right. So Santosh did mention that today we are going to cover Google search ads. Absolutely. Anything else? Who wants to just go ahead and let me know what topic are we going to be covering today? We'll just get started. Just waiting for a few more minutes, guys. Before I begin, I hope I can take your questions in case you have any questions from the absolutely right, Shashank. Keyword match types is another topic which we would be taking today, which we would be covering today. And ad extensions, absolutely right. So all of you are from different batches also. Some of you are from the same batch. We have a different audience altogether. That's great. And for some of you, it might be a sort of a refresher in terms of Google search ads. This session is getting recorded, guys, so which is great. I would also, is this AdWords from starting? Absolutely. This is almost from starting only, Ashish. It was just a 5-minute thing which we spoke about AdWords in the last session. So you haven't really missed much. So I'll start creating advertisements right from the beginning this time, and let's get started, guys. So all in all, what I want you, before we begin with the search ads, I hope everybody is on the same page and understands what are search ads and what are display ads, the difference between Google search ads and Google display ads. And the other difference which I want to understand from you guys is that you are aware of what are organic listings and what are paid search listing, guys. So can I get a yes or a no from each one of you? I hope the understanding is there with each and every one. Aditya, Ashish, Dhruv, Nitin, Sanjeevan. Welcome to the session, Aditya and Sanjeevan. All right, so the understanding is there. Dhruv says yes, Ashish says yes, Nitin says yes. All right, guys. So all in all, whenever we go ahead and start creating Google search ads, which are, excuse me, paid ads, excuse me, I'm having a bad throat with some cough. That's why I'll keep coughing in between. Just bear with me with that. I'll go ahead and open google.com. And whenever we are using a search engine like Google search engine, as a user, let's say if I'm typing in a particular keyword, which is a query of mine, that's there in my head. I want to buy a Canadian phone number from the Skype, or let's say if I want to buy an iPhone, that's one of the favorite example which I keep giving all the times. If I want to buy an iPhone, I use search engine, and the query which I type in the search engine to gather information about iPhone 6, since I want to buy that, that query is also called keyword, which all of you know that. I don't want to repeat that again and again. And once we press enter, guys, then the next thing which comes in the search results, these are the paid search results which we are trying to learn to get our advertisement also, to get our website also on the top, just like this. All right, the example which I'm going to take today is going to be my website, which is dmpaathshala.com. I know some of you have been already given websites from free websites from my end. Santosh, I have to give your website. I'll surely give it to you tomorrow. Dhruv, you have your website. Shashank has a website. And Ashish, I'll provide you a website too. And whosoever gets subscribes to the overall course would be getting a website, right? So you can use your website to create advertisement for your website. Your website URL should come on the top of the targeted keywords. Now, when I say targeted keywords, how do we, but we were supposed to continue with Google AdWords account setting. Absolutely, we're coming on to that, Santosh. So I'm just sort of recapping the stuff. So once I give you the website, we will start with the settings part, how to create Google search ads. And these are the search ads, guys. So it's a recap which I'm doing from the last session, right? So whosoever has attended the last session would be knowing that we understood what a keyword means. A keyword which is entered into a query which is entered into the Google search box by the user of the search engine. That particular query is called a keyword. And when a keyword is pressed in, these top three search listings which you see are there of anybody's website, whether it's eBay or it's Amazon or it's Apple. They have tried to get their website on the top of the search results with the help of Google AdWords. Now, Google AdWords is one of the products which Google provides to advertiser through which they can create these text ads. Why we call it text ads? Because we don't see a picture right up here, right? These are certain text ads, and we can also create that for our website and get our website on the top. Let's get that started. I want each one of you to create your a new account, guys, a new Google AdWords account, because I would be giving you some certain coupons in case you are, hi Guru Prasad, in case you guys are planning to spend some money on these ads for just doing some experimentation, then I would give you certain coupon which will get enabled only on a new Google ad, new Gmail ID or new Google account, whatever you want to say it. Once you have created a new Google account, guys, what you really need to do is go ahead and start typing in adwords.google.com. All right. Now, once I type in adwords.google.com, that's the platform where we'll create these advertisements. Okay. Keep asking me questions wherever you feel that there's something which you want to, which you're not clear of, which you're not clear about, guys. So I would encourage you to do that, please. Just a second. So it's getting refreshed, guys. All right. So what's happened? Since I have an existing account, I have an account which is already, I have created certain campaigns in the past and certain ads. That's why it looks like this. So don't get worried. I'll talk for next half an hour, guys. We'll study some theoretical part, and then we'll talk about the overall settings, the ad extension, and the keyword match types. All right. So I'm referring certain presentations. I'm going to give you the links for those presentations also, which I'm referring to. I have uploaded my presentations, which I keep using for my lectures. I've uploaded them on my website also and on SlideShare as well. So if you go to slideshare.net, you can type in Digital Marketing Paathshala. There you would get. All right. All right, so this is the very first lecture which I'm going to take today. The very first presentation. Okay, this is somehow, okay, this is not working. What I would do, I'm not really sure why this is showing a 404. I would go ahead and open it from my personal stuff. Just a second. Excuse me. Hi, Faisal. Good evening. So today we are talking about search ads, keyword match types, and ad extensions. Just bear with me for a minute. I'm just opening the presentation, guys. Okay, cool. So that's the very first lecture. I just want to showcase you a AdWords certification. How does it look like? So once you go ahead, you're done with the Google AdWords, you can go ahead and start giving in your exam for Google AdWords. That is something which you can do. And once you're clear that, that's how the certificate looks like. Certain good to know stuff that India is going digital. I have someone. Can we take individually? Absolutely, you can take that individually. Yes, as a particular individual, you can go ahead and apply for that. I mean, give a test and then get that. So each and everybody over here would get a Google AdWords and Analytics certificate initially by me, and then later on you can go ahead and take that. So it doesn't require any fees if you're getting it, if you're getting associated with me, which is with Digital Marketing Paathshala. So I'll get that free for you. Otherwise, they do keep charging. Their fees keep changing. Sometimes they make it free. Sometimes they get it chargeable for $100 or sometimes $45. All right. Okay. So how many people are using internet? I don't want to go ahead with that. You would probably would be knowing all that stuff with the speech Mr. Narendra Modi gives whenever. So recently he got that Digital India campaign. He launched that and where there he spoke about all that. So okay, that's the introduction part, guys. I hope the video is in sync. So where does the overall need for Google AdWords comes in? This is the overall process which explains why Google AdWords are important for an advertiser. An advertiser is a client who needs more traffic on their website, right? So let's say if I'm a client and I sell across iPhones, and if I have to sell them across for paid advertisement, absolutely, we need Google AdWords for that. So if I have a website where I'm listed my product, which is iPhone, which I'm selling, I need more people to come onto my website and buy them. But for getting more people, targeted people onto my website, I have to advertise somewhere. And search engine is the best, is a good place where I would go ahead and advertise my stuff. Many people are, you know, the end buyers are always using search engines and they're looking for information to, you know, in terms of acquiring, they're using search engines to acquire a lot of information about the same products, which the client is ready to sell. So the buyer and the seller both get connected on the search engines. And these search engines are majorly, you know, Google is being used the most. And the end customer types in the query, which is also called the keyword. With the help of keyword, the end customer is able to get these search results, and we as clients get our paid advertisements on the top for those keywords. I hope most of you are aware about this part. I've already spoken about the paid and the non-paid. I'm skipping that part since you're already knowing that. These paid ads are also called pay-per-click ads, guys. PPC ads, this is another name. Right, so PPC ads is this another name, and these non-paid search results, even it makes a lot of sense to get our website you know, in the search results for this particular column, which is underneath the paid ads. I mean, if we are not able to get our website, you know, this is a bit of costly affair, but this is if we take it from a longer term perspective, this is bit cheap. I mean, a lesser costly affair, which is called SEO listings, which we will cover in another module. SEO stands for search engine optimization. These rankings, these search results are called organic results or natural results, guys, or non-paid results. And these ones are the paid results or the pay-per-click ads, right? This is the introduction part. Today, I'm deliberately using the, what do you say? A presentation with respect to Google AdWords, so that once I cover the theoretical part, we'll come on to the practical part also. So what AdWords is, it's an online advertising platform, right? So where you use to make people come onto your website and get specific information and then buy a product from your place. There's one thing, guys, which I want to make it clear, and this concept should be clear to most of you, that there are two products by Google. One is called AdWords and the other one is AdSense. They both appear to be same because they have the common word as ad, but they both are different products altogether. AdWords is a platform which is used by advertisers. When I say advertisers, all those clients, brands who are always looking to spend money and get their advertisement at various places. And AdSense is altogether a different thing, which is for publishers. So Faisal says it's opposite of each other, and AdSense is used by bloggers. Absolutely, Faisal, Guru Prasad, you are aware of that. I would request, so I just want to understand, if somebody who's not aware of difference between AdWords and AdSense, I can go ahead and explain it to you. So AdWords, right, I would, yeah, so Faisal, I would recommend you to speak, have English as the language only for, so Faisal says AdSense is a platform from where you can earn money as a publisher. As a publisher, you can earn money with the help of AdSense, and with the help of AdWords, you can buy traffic and you can spend money to get traffic. No problem, Faisal, try whichever way you want to do it. All right, so it's perfectly fine. Let me give you an example of an AdWords and AdSense, guys. Is everybody clear on the AdWords or AdSense? Santosh, are you clear? Dhruv, I hope you are aware of that. So Ashish is aware. Guru Prasad is aware. In case somebody is not, let me know. Dhruv says yes. Shashank says yes. Santosh says yes. Okay. In case you guys are already known to this, so I would not spend time on this. Manu, Sanjeevan, all those who have joined in for the first time, you can let me know. I can spend 5 minutes and let you know the difference between AdWords and AdSense, guys. It's very important in case you are trying to build your career into digital marketing. The difference between these two should be clear. All right, so I'm not getting, okay, Sanjeevan, you are clear on that part. And okay, Manu says, okay, so I'm just going to take it for Manu for just, Faisal, you might have to restart again. All right. So let's say if I have, so this is my website, guys, dmpaathshala.com. Okay. Excuse me, guys. I have a bad throat. So if you see, this is my website wherein, which is dmpaathshala.com. What is the objective of my website? My website is there to give information to all those who want to get digital marketing training, right? How would I promote this if I'm using ad? I mean, if I have to use Google services, Google ad services, then I would use Google AdWords and I will try to get my ad up on the top of the search results for keywords like digital marketing training, online marketing training. So that if somebody types in, let's say if Manu types in online marketing training in Google search engine, then the DM Paathshala text ad should appear. Then what is happening? Digital Marketing Paathshala, which is me, I am creating ads with the help of AdWords, and these ads are getting appeared on the search engines, and Manu as the customer or the prospect or the or sort of a searcher, you know, an information seeker, is typing the same keyword for which I am running ad. And who am I? Digital Marketing Paathshala. Digital Marketing Paathshala is the advertiser in this case. This is scenario one, Manu. I hope that's clear to you. So where DMP becomes the advertiser, right? So let me know in case it's still not clear. I can surely help you. DMP becomes the advertiser and DMP gets the ads up on Google search engine. And I make my ad appear, I set it in a certain fashion that my ad should appear for end customers whenever they type in keywords like digital marketing training or online marketing training. That is where advertiser use a Google AdWords to get their ads up and get targeted traffic. All right. Excuse me. And the other scenario is if I am using a website where I'm getting a lot of traffic. Okay. Now I'm a publisher now. What I'm doing, I'm not using ad services or the AdWord platform, but I want to now make money with the help of my website. So many people are visiting my website on day-to-day basis, all right? When so many people, let's say 1,000 people are coming onto my website or 10,000 people are coming onto my website, I want to make money out of that. I would go to Google and tell them that I have a website which is into digital marketing space and I want to rent out certain space on my website. Can you see? I have already rented out certain space on my website. And if you see where my cursor is, it would say add choices. Okay, it's not saying right now. Yeah, it says add by Google. I hope you can see that, Manu, everybody. This is what I have done, I have gone to, I have subscribed to another product of Google, which is called Google AdSense. The way you subscribe to them is by just, open google.com/AdSense. Tell Google that you are a publisher. When you say a publisher, you are a website owner. You create a lot of content on your website. This is the category of your website. The category of my website is digital marketing. The domain is this. And I tell that, I'm getting good, decent traffic. I'm promoting it. And I tell Google that I want to, convert this traffic. I want to use that traffic and I want to sell a certain space, a certain real estate. When I say a real estate, a certain, a space on my website to any third party who can come and buy space on my website. So Google becomes a mediator. And this particular person, if you see, when I open their website, which is Orient Digital, this is Orient Digital is a digital marketing agency. They have approached Google with the help of Google AdWords. Okay. And I have approached Digital Marketing Paathshala, have approached Google with the help of AdSense. I have sold my space. These people have bought my space, and Google have actually made both of us connect with each other. Google have become a mediator. Google charges a certain share of it. All right. Certain share of the money which this Orient Digital would be spending. So party one is this particular advertiser, which is Orient Digital. Party two is Digital Marketing Paathshala, which is a publisher, which is me, who has sold the space. I have sold my space. I have told Google that I want to rent certain space, and Google says that I have got a buyer. So the buyer and me being the seller of the space, we both meet, and Google charges us, Google gets paid a certain commission out of it. What happens when an end customer comes onto the website and clicks on this particular advertisement, okay? Let's say Orient Digital have said that I can pay 50 rupees on every click which will happen. End customer clicks on this. Now, 50 rupees will transfer from Orient Digital's pocket. And out of 50 rupees, guys, 60% of the money will go into Google's pocket, since Google is the mediator. And rest 40% of that money, which will go to the website owner who has rented out the space, which is the publisher. So I, being the publisher, have rented out my space with the help of AdSense. So what is happening with the help of AdSense? I'm earning money, right? So I have a question from Shubham. How much it takes and distribute to admin of website? I'm sorry. Can you explain your question again? How much it takes for what, Shubham? If I try to understand, has anybody, how much? So it's a 60-40 ratio, Shubham. Like I already told you, the money always fluctuate. Okay. Orient Digital might be ready to pay 50 rupees for the click, or they might be ready to pay 1000 rupees or 500 rupees. A bidding happens. We'll come on to that part, the bidding part also. But does that answer your question? Or if not, you can still go ahead and ask me. Guru Prasad says this advertiser made some mistake because he's placing his ad in digital marketing platform, which is already rendering the same service. I hope so. No, they have a different service, Guru Prasad. They're into servicing and I'm into training. So there's a close relation. This website is Digital Marketing Paathshala is all about providing digital marketing training. And these people, this is a digital agency, right? All right. So Shubham, does that answer your question? Let me know. I would move ahead. All right. In case, guys, you are not able to still get your answers clear, I'm always available on WhatsApp and email. That's the best way. Again, you can get in touch with me. I would try my level best to answer all your questions over here only. Okay, where exactly is my... Just a sec, guys. Right. Okay, so that's the difference between AdWords and AdSense, guys. And this particular slide talks about different ad formats. Before we move further, I want to tell you that with the help of Google AdWords, we cannot just make these text ads. When I say text ads, this is a written text, right? We can always make image ads also and video ads also, advertisements within the videos, all right? So image ads, video ads, and text ads. We'll begin with the text ads, which are also called search ads, guys. And the image and the video ads are part of display ads. The overall slide is self-explanatory. I hope you guys have understood that part. All right. Okay, forget that part. So where does advert comes in? So we have advertisers. Now, I would be taking example of Digital Marketing Paathshala being an advertiser. If I want to get in touch with many more people who would like to get digital marketing training, do you think AdWords is a good platform for me, guys? Help me understand that if you can answer. Right. So yes, says Dhruv, absolutely. So if I want to get more people, want to get in touch with all those participants or all those people who want to learn digital marketing, maybe then as an advertiser, I would be using Google AdWords. That's what I would take in this scenario. And later on, I would request each one of you to make use of your personal websites and run, create, and make advertisements. Sorry. Accordingly, just a second. Why is this troubling me? Okay, great, Shubham. Yeah, I know you have your website, so you can go ahead and create for that. That'll be great. So, okay. So there are advertisers and there is always a bid on the keywords like an auction. I hope most of you know what an auction means. Like in Bollywood movies, we always used to see that Nilami thing, right? People used to auction, people used to make bids that I am ready to pay 50 rupees for this price. I'm ready to pay 51. Then another person used to come and say 52. And the person with the highest bid used to get that particular product. Over here, there's always a bid which every advertiser is making in order to get their website on the top. Why won't we like our website to be on the top? We will always want our website on the top because the probability of maximum traffic, being achieved is going to be only for that search result, which is on the top. The second search result will get a little lesser share of the overall traffic coming from that keyword, and similarly so forth and so on. The fourth, the fifth, and the sixth, they'll have lesser amount of traffic as compared to the ones above them. So that's why the bid system happens, guys. And it says the advertiser who bids for the highest amounts get the highest position. That's not actually true, because if you would see the last line, it says if your ad performs well, the amount you have to pay per click also decreases. With the bid, there are two things, guys, with the because of which the overall rank of a particular search result matters. One is bid and other is quality score. I will come on to that. So quality score and bid are two different things, because of which the absolutely right, Guru Prasad. And the quality score is dependent upon ad copy, landing page, and it's Guru Prasad, it's CTR. The last one is CTR. So I'll come on to that part. So as you will keep running your ads for longer period of time, your per click cost will keep decreasing because you will optimize your ads as you will move further. All right. Okay, let's get started and let's understand how this overall thing will work. That's the very first screenshot of how you would go ahead and start doing it. When you type in adwords.google.com on Google search, you would need to enter your search, your username and password. Pretty easy stuff. It'll ask you for the time zone and the country you are in. So go ahead and type in India and start moving ahead. And once you do that, your AdWords account is created. This is the particular screen, guys, which you would see. It will ask you to create your first campaign. Now, there are three things I want to let you know for which you want to be sure of, which you should be knowing. There are within a Google AdWords account, there is a particular structure of Google AdWords account, guys. You have a campaign, then you have a ad copy, and then between ad copy and campaign, you have the ad group, sorry. Yeah, that's what. You have a campaign and then you have a ad group. All right, so I'm writing the overall structure, absolutely right. And bit underneath ad group, you have the ad copies. Okay, so I'm going to tell you how the structure looks like. You always have the topmost thing is an account. So you will always have an account, a Google AdWords account, which will be associated to your username, your email ID and your password. Account would be the topmost thing. And after account, in descending order, then you have a campaign. And then after campaign, then you have an ad group, guys. And after every ad group, you have an ad copy. This is a structure. Okay, I'm telling you, one unique account, absolutely right, Guru Prasad. So let me move further down. This would be the particular place where you would see it will ask you to create your first campaign. I will come on to that part. We'll start creating in a campaign also. But let me try to make you understand first of all. I'm skipping that part. I'm going to come on to this. Let me first make you understand the overall structure. Structure of Google AdWords. Okay. Focus on this particular slide, guys. This is the overall structure of Google AdWords. Now, why a structure is there? It's like everything has a place and a management needs to be there. If we see a particular website, do you guys, you guys would be all knowing that there is always a particular navigation which is being used. What exactly we mean by a navigation, guys? So you would always see a top menu on the top, you know, on the top of every website. You would always see things like, let me show you with an example, any website. Let's say even this one. So you have the DM Paathshala one. You always, okay, this is the navigation or this is the overall top menu. If you see, you have various content on your website classified in different segments. You have a forum separately, you have a job section separate, you have a contact us page separate, you have a blog page defined separately, then you have a courses page, then you have the about us page. If I go into the courses page, you will always see pages underneath the courses pages also. Overall courses which are defined comes underneath this. Okay, why is this? Okay, just a sec. Right, so this is, let's say this is about us page. I would rather like to showcase you an e-commerce site where you would see how the overall management. A categorization happens. You always see, the apparel section to be on one side and then the electronics. So you always have recharges and bill payments as one of the section, then mobile, tablets, and underneath mobile and tablets, you have, let's say, mobiles as one of the section and tablets, another section, mobile accessories. So this is a major category. Then you have a subcategory, and underneath a subcategory, you have a subcategory, and underneath a major category, subcategory, and subcategory, you have all the products listed. Right. The reason why these categories, subcategories and subcategories are created so that things are much more defined in a proper managed fashion. Right. Similarly, we have a Google AdWords account being managed with the help of this particular segmentation, which I'm talking about. This segmentation help is like this. You have an account on the top and then you have unique email address and a password and a billing information. A billing information, you always need a credit or a debit card to get attached to your Google AdWords account, since you would be paying to Google for running your ads up, right? You are paying on per click basis. Only one particular billing information is needed. I mean, you can attach definitely 2 to 3 credit cards also, but only one tab is there in overall account which has a billing information. Only one specific email ID and one specific password is attached to an account. Underneath an account, you can create multiple campaigns, guys. Okay. And underneath a campaign, you can see there are multiple ad groups. Why this is like this? How can we use coupons? Okay. I'll come on to that part. Coupons can be used only for new accounts, and I'll give you that, Guru Prasad. Once you enter your billing information, I'll give you a coupon where you can go ahead and enter that. So it needs either a debit or a credit card, and coupons are with me. I will share with each one of you. Right. So coming on to the campaign and the ad group, let's say if I have a website which is Snapdeal only, I take the same example. I have a mobile and tablet. All right. What was here? If you see, mobile and tablet was the major category, and under mobile and tablets, you had mobile accessories, another subcategory, and then you had Bluetooth devices. So mobile is a subcategory, tablet is a subcategory, right? If I go on to create different campaigns, I can take mobile and tablets as one of the campaign guys, okay? Mobile and tablets is one of the campaigns. Underneath a campaign, I can create mobile as one of the ad group and tablets as one of the another ad group. The reason is that I want to make sure that specific ads are made for specific products. I don't want my keyword, let's say a particular person is typing in a keyword buy iPhone 6 and my advertisement says we sell all kind of products and services. We sell everything from A to Z. That doesn't make sense. I'll come on to that part and show you some examples. Things will get more clear to you. So just get to know this get this inside your head, guys, that after account, you have a campaign. A campaign like this can be, let's say, the apparel campaign, and you have the electronics campaign. All right. So within the apparel campaign, you can have a different ad group like a men apparels and another ad group being a women apparels. All right. Guru Prasad says, is there any limitation? No, there is no limitation to creating ad groups or even campaigns. Up to 10,000 campaigns can be created. And underneath every campaign, there can be 10,000 ad groups. And underneath every, And underneath every ad group, there can be 10,000 different ad copies. So 10,000 is the maximum limit, but generally nobody is able to use that. Even the biggie websites. Because they create multiple. It takes a lot of hard work to create multiple campaigns and multiple ad groups and multiple ad copies. But that's where the role of a digital marketer comes in. Okay, Nathan, no problem. I know you have already you already know about these, but you can leave. No problem. You can refer to the recorded session. So thanks, Nathan, for letting me know. So similarly, guys, like I was telling you, the way you can differentiate between a good digital marketer and a bad digital marketer is, or a lazy digital marketer and an active digital marketer is, a lazy digital marketer will create just, probably one or two campaigns, and within one or two campaigns for every different keywords, he would actually go ahead and create one generic ad, which might say, we sell all electronics and garments for men and for women, and let's say, and they run it, he would run it for all different kind of keywords. Now, what is happening when somebody is typing a particular keyword, I want to buy an iPhone 6, and he gets to see a particular ad which says something of this sort, that Amazon sells electronics, men clothes, women clothes, kids clothes, home appliances, furniture, everything. We are an e-commerce organization. We sell everything. It doesn't make sense because you have to always talk to the point. You enter into Big Bazaar. Let's say I'm giving you an example. You enter into a Big Bazaar showroom and you tell him that I'm looking for, cell phones cover, a mobile phone cover, which is a Samsung S6. Now he says, we sell everything, sir. I mean, you come over and we'll give you everything. And then you ask him specifically, do you have that? You go. He tells you, we sell everything. We sell kid clothes, men clothes. It doesn't make sense to you. The person who's trying to look for us, who's looking for an information, wants a specific information, right? Somebody is able to control my stuff. Okay. I'm not really sure why. Okay, sorry, control was there with everybody. Okay, so every campaign, guys, have a daily budget. I can instruct to Google AdWords that my daily budget is just 1,000 rupees. Till the time my daily budget doesn't get exhausted, my campaign will run. I can set location targeting. I want to show my ads only to specific locations, you know, in certain specific locations in Delhi, in Pune, in Mumbai. I can do that. I can even exclude places, guys. Let's say if I want to target entire India, I can do that. And just don't want my advertisement to show to people residing in Goa. I can do that too. So campaign has the location targeting, daily budget settings, language targeting setting, absolutely the radius targeting, you're right, Guru Prasad, which comes underneath location targeting. Then we have a distribution preference. A distribution preference is a functionality, guys, where I would show that in the practical sense also, where I can give information to Google that I want to distribute my ad, I want to show my ad on a faster pace. The moment my budget starts from zero, it should, my advertisement should keep on kept on showcasing to end customers till the time my budget doesn't get exhausted. So let's say if my budget gets exhausted, the keywords for which I'm running is very highly competitive. So many people are typing for it, and my budget gets exhausted because of that so much high search volume of that keyword which I've chosen. It gets exhausted within 2 hours. Then this is a scenario one in distribution preference. Then there is a standard preference. There are 2 types of distribution preference. One is accelerated, which I've already told you. The other one is standard, where you can tell Google in the standard scenario, you can tell Google always that my ad should be shown for the smaller budget I have throughout the day. Let's say if the keyword is highly competitive, Google will do. It will distribute the overall ad in the entire day for whatever time period I have chosen. I'll come on to that and show you. I can even send, instruct Google on the start date and end date of my advertisement. Let's say if I am promoting a New Year event or an Independence Day event, and I want my advertisement to run only till 15th of August. After that, there is no relevance for it because the event is on 15th August. I'm selling tickets for that event, let's say. Till 15th August, 10 a.m. in the morning, I want my tickets to be sold and my ads to be run up till that time. Now, I don't have a resource who can log in every time on the AdWords and do start the campaign, pause the campaign, end the campaign. I can give instructions. Automatically, these things can happen. My daily budget can be changed, n number of times in a day. If I say I have just 1,000 rupees, I can do that. If I say I just have 100 rupees in a day, I can do that too. Whenever I want to change location, language, distribution preference, start date, end date, I can do that for every campaign. Now, I hope the categorization is clear to you. You have a main account. Underneath the main account, you have 2 different campaigns. One of the examples which I gave you, like for what Snapdeal would do, electronics is being one of the campaign, and clothes being another campaign, that is campaign 2. You can have multiple campaigns, campaign 3, 4, 5, 6, up to 10,000. And underneath every campaign, you have an ad group, guys. Now, let's say it was electronics. Underneath electronics, you have an ad group, which is one of the ad group is mobile, and the other ad group can be a tablet. And underneath ad groups, guys, there are keywords and ad copies. When I say ad copies are these text which you always see, in the search results. Let me showcase that to you. I hope most of you are aware of that. I did showcase that. So the text ads which are there, that is actually called an ad copy. What the end customer gets to see is only the ad copy. The end customer never gets to see what is the campaign. I don't know what would be the campaign for Apple in their AdWords account. I won't be knowing underneath which particular ad group this particular ad copy is there. What I know that this is a search ad or the other name, a search ad or a text ad or a ad copy. These are same name to a particular thing, guys. Ad copy or a text ad or a search ad. If somebody uses all these 3 terms, it means the same, which are these. All right, I hope I'm clear on that part. I'm moving ahead with this particular structure. If you have certain questions, feel free to ask me. So that's the overall structure. You have a campaign, underneath a campaign, you have ad groups, and underneath ad groups, All right, so I have a question. Shubham is asking me that I sometimes see advertisements on the bottom. Absolutely right, Shubham. Google doesn't just showcases advertisements on the top of the page, but it also showcases advertisements sometimes on the bottom. Your ad can come on the bottom, your ad can come on the right, and your ad can come on the top. I want to tell you one thing. Maximum ads which can be there on one search result page, this is called a search result page, guys. This is one SERP. This is called an SERP. Absolutely right, Shubham. 11. That's the one. 8 on the right hand side is the maximum. 8 on the right hand side and 3 on the top or on the bottom. So the rest three is distributed either on the top or the bottom. If you will see 2 on the top, then you will always see only 1 on the bottom. So the top and the bottom always is distributed between 3, and 8 is the maximum which you would always see on the right hand side. So Shubham, you can feel free to type in the public chat also, in place of private, no problem in that. Thanks for asking the question, Shubham. So 8 plus 3 is the maximum, guys. All right, which leads to 11 paid ads maximum in a search engine result page. I'm telling you again, it's SERP, which is called search engine results, research in a results page. So this is one SERP, guys. Then you have, this is a second SERP. All right. And you can see 3 advertisements on the top, right? And these are the non-paid ones, which is with the help of the SEO. And the SEO ones or the natural listings are maximum 10 in a page. Coming back to my same presentation, which I'm using. So after ad groups, you have ad copies. I've already told you what are the ad copies. I've shown you the end customer only gets to see the ad copies. All right. So if I go further down, this is again another example where you can see a promo campaign. So I'm not taking a couple of campaigns. I'm showcasing you the structure of one of the advertiser who owns an auto repair shop. When I say auto repair, an automobile repair shop. I hope, how does an automobile repair shop looks like? You guys can visualize in your mind that you have taken your bike or your car to a specific automobile repair shop. What sort of things do they do? They can either check AC for your car. They can either check brakes. So they do a lot of stuff, right? So they have services of AC repair, brake repair, or oil change. They can also do, car washing. I mean, plenty of things. All these things can be, car washing is a different service altogether. But so car washing, washing would be a different campaign. Now you have the repair. Anything to do with repair of an automobile is another campaign. Automobile, a garage would have multiple things to which they offer. And one of the section being the repair section. And within the repair, oil change, brake repair, and AC repairs are 3 services, right? So ad group 1 is being referred as oil change. Ad group 2 is being referred as brake repair. Ad group 3 as AC repair. Now have a look how things have been placed over here. Underneath this ad group, I hope you remember that underneath an ad group, an ad copy comes. You can see an ad copy which is being created here. Oil change is the theme of the ad group. You can see oil change is used in their headline. Okay. And even this is a headline, guys, which is always in the blue text. And this is the display text, which is always display URL, which is always in the green. So Ashish says, can two ad groups have same keywords? Absolutely, they can have, but they will always be in competition. Ashish, great question. So two ad groups have same keywords, but they'll be in competition with each other. So you can see, guys, the theme oil change is same theme is being presented in the headline. And if you see on the bottom, which is called the description line 1 and description line 2, there are two things to it. Within the description line also, you can see oil change being mentioned. That's the way the relevancy should be maintained whenever we are trying to create ads, guys. Okay. You can see after the ad copy is being created, keywords are associated to it. Discounted oil change is one keyword for which this ad will always pop up. Express oil change is another keyword for which this ad will pop up. Now that's how an advertiser has created and shaped up. shaped up the entire ad, the AdWords platform. The overall, ad grouping has been done in such a fashion. Similarly, the first keyword has an oil change, second keyword express oil change shops, quick oil change, synthetic oil change. All the oil change related keywords have been grouped under ad group one, which has a theme again of oil change, and ad copy also talk about oil change. Somebody who types in any of these keywords will find this ad copy and it will definitely strike in their mind that yes, the customer is looking for oil change, and the customer gets to see the ad about oil change. A close relation, a close knit is there, that's why the chances of clicking on the ad is going to be way higher. Whenever you have maximum clicks on an ad, after seeing them, then your CTR improves. I'll come on to the CTR part. I did spoke about CTR in the last session, but I'll talk about it again, which is called click-through rate. Click-through rate always improves with these policies which I'm telling you. The relevancy has to be maintained. Similarly, the second ad group has a break repair, theme, and the overall keywords and the ad copy are all about brake repair. Similarly, for the AC repair, the keywords and the ad copy, you can see, have the same theme, which is of AC repair. If you follow the same theme, what will happen whenever a person, the end customer will type in brake repair, your advertisement will appear on the search engine, right? Your advertisement will appear on the search engine, and if your if the keyword and the ad copy matches, the chances of the customer clicking on your ad rather than on your competitor ad is going to be way higher. Your competitor's ad might not be that attractive as yours. I mean, you can make it attractive either by certain words, or you can even make it attractive by having the relevancy right up here. Ashish says, sir, suppose if I want to add auto repair keyword, which ad group we're going to add, as they all three ad group will have same keyword. I would always suggest in such kind of situation, Ashish, have another campaign, another ad group altogether. Have, auto repair kind of keywords, auto repair kind of, the ad copy. Don't merge them in any of these three. If I have auto repair as my campaign name, but if I feel that auto repairs is in itself is also a service, like these three repair services, like these three services, the brake, oil, and third one? Brake, oil, and AC. Auto repair is also another service which people type in. Then I would create another ad group and associate, related keywords and have associate a related ad copy to it. I hope that answers your question, Ashish. All right. So with this particular relevancy, people, let's say five people will see your ad. With good relevancy, four might click on it. If you have a bad relevancy, out of five, more probably one will click on it. Your ad appears five times and only in front of five people, and your ad is out of five, only one person clicks on it. So you have one click divided by, five impressions. Your ad gets appeared, it means it's an impression. So one click divided by five impressions into 100 will give you the CTR. Scenario 2, four people click. Out of those five people, again, who have seen your ad, because the relevancy was there, so you check the CTR in the second one scenario and you get a CTR in the second scenario too. Tell me which one is better, guys. Scenario 1 or Scenario 2? I need an answer from you. CTR of the Scenario 1 is better or Scenario 2? Guru Prasad says Scenario 2 is better. How about others? Ashish? Ashish said number 2. Manu? Shashank says 2. Sanjeevan? Shubham says 2. All right. How about Partha Sarthi? Manu says 2nd. Okay, Santosh, I'll repeat the question. The average industry CTR is 4 to 5%. Is it correct? Not right, Dhruv. 4 to 5% is the conversion, I would say. CTR can be more than that also. So that's the conversion average. So for every industry, Dhruv, there is a different industry average CTR. Santosh, I'll just repeat the question. So for every industry, it's a different group. So I can't really comment on that. Education, real estate, e-commerce, they all have different. Santosh, the question was that I have two scenarios, okay, where scenario one, your ad appears five times when five different people write in a keyword on the Google search engine. So it means five impressions are there. Five people typing in the same keyword, getting to see your ad along with your competitors also. Out of those five people, one person only gets to see your ad. I mean, gets to click onto your ad. So one click out of the five impressions into 100 will give you a CTR in that case. All right. Yeah, absolutely 80%. And scenario two, Santosh, four people clicking out of in the same set of people, out of all those same set of people, out of those five people, four people click on it. So four out of five into 100 would give you a CTR for the second scenario. Scenario one, only one person clicking out of those five who are looking into your ad. Scenario two, four people clicking out of the five people who have seen your ad. One click divided by five impressions, scenario one, four clicks divided by five impressions, which is a better scenario in terms of, good, you know, good advertisement campaign being running across. Second one says Dhruv. Santosh says, okay, Santosh, you've got that. Great. Thanks, Manu. Partha Sarthi, I hope you have joined in a bit late. That's why just trying to ask you, have you got that? In case not, let me know. Sanjeevan, how about you? And I have someone else whose name is not appearing. All right. So Partha Sarthi, Sanjeevan, let me know in case any further questions. I'm moving ahead. All right. So that's about the overall campaign structure. Now comes the ad creation part, guys. All right. There's a way through which we can, there's certain ways which we should be taking care into consideration while creating advertisements. Okay. Thanks, Partha Sarthi, for replying. Have a look at these two advertisements and just want to tell you, somebody types in a keyword 8 megapixel camera. Let's say you as a customer of, or you as an information seeker or an online shopper, you need an 8 megapixel camera. You type in this query, which is there in your mind, which is also a keyword. You type this keyword into Google search engine, which is a better ad. So Ashish says second. Shashank says second. Are you guys sure? Can be the first one also. Dhruv says second. Guys, just be confident if you are typing in second. I would always ask you for the logics. So keep Ashish says second. Shashank says second. Dhruv says second. Ashish says I am confident. All right. Anybody else who wants to try? Shubham, Sanjeevan, Manu says second. All right. Guru Prasad says second. Sanjeevan says second. All right. Sanjeevan, since you haven't spoken much, I would give you the priority, the preference of letting me know what's the logic behind the second one. Why would you say, Sanjeevan, the second one is a better one? Santosh, how about you? Which one you think is a much better one? Right, so Guru Prasad has answered that, but there can be another reason. So let me know, guys. Okay, let me know your logics behind that. Shubham says, Guru Prasad says it has got the keyword, and okay, so there's off topic written. I chose that because it got given 8 megapixel and 10%. Shubham says keyword, right keyword, 10% discount, call to action, attraction. Absolutely. All of you have said that, right? So there is a call to action. There is attraction. There is relevancy. There is discount. There is keyword embedded into it. I believe, Santosh, you are clear on that. So you also did answer. I didn't see. I have a small chat window today on a Mac laptop. This chat window doesn't really stretches up much. All right, guys. So absolutely, the answer is second ad. And the reason for second ad being the most, better one, this one is going to perform better because it talks the same stuff which I'm searching for, which the end customer is searching for. 8 megapixel camera, and I get to see in the ad that, yes, 8 megapixel camera. Over here, you get to see just a lazy Google AdWord guy having a generic ad, running it for even for a keyword like 8 megapixel camera, which is not good. You should have as many campaigns and as many ad groups and as many keywords dissected so that your quality score always improves. And I can tell you this particular keyword, this particular ad and this particular keyword, both of them will get a better quality score. You know, a quality score is a sort of a ranking, or I would say a score which is being given by Google for every keyword with out of 10. If much more, quality score is there, higher the quality score, on a lesser price, by paying less amount, you can get your ad on the top. So Guru Prasad says, absolutely rank into CTR Dhruv. Absolutely, that's the... Guru Prasad says, if someone looking for camera, then first ad may appear. Absolutely. So if I'm looking for just for a camera, if I say, looking for a camera store, an online camera store, maybe then that one, this particular would really make sense. Another thing which you can see, not just the relevancy part, the keyword matches to this particular headline. The second ad does also have a call to action, a motivation, or something in their text which really excites the end customer to click on it. This is called a call to action. Free delivery, buy today, 10% off. I mean, these are called call to actions which we should have always within our search ads. Whenever we are building ad copies, guys, these particular text would be typed across by us. In case you're not good at writing, I always recommend you at least type in those keywords for which you're making ad copies within Google search engine and get to see what your competitors have also written in their ads. Any ads which is ranking on the top probably might be doing something good. I hope it makes sense. You can learn some lessons from your competitors also while creating these ad copies. Even for choosing keywords, you can always check for your competitor's website and your competitor's advertisements. Make sense? I mean, you can always benchmark your competitor who's doing well in this particular sphere. All right. So this is how you create an ad copy. Again, a theoretical stuff, guys. We will do the practical also. A headline is always created with 25 characters. Then you have a description line 1, description line 2 with 35. Every space is counted. Can I go with online camera shopping? I couldn't get your question. So when you go with online camera shopping, what is the question like, Parthasarthi? If you can just let me know in detail. Not really sure. So when you type in online camera shopping, okay, I'm waiting for your question. No problem. So when I was telling you about the ad copy, within an ad copy, even a single space is being counted as a character. A headline should have can have maximum 25 characters. Then you have a description line 1, description line 2, 35 characters. Then you have a display and a destination URL. I'll tell you the difference between these two. Guru Prasad says, if we copy the competitor, can we get the top place? No, never copy the competitor. Always get an understanding from them, because competitor is bidding for the same. Never ever copy the competitor, Guru Prasad, because your ad can also get banned and your account can also get suspended. That's the answer. Parthasarthi, if you ask me a question, can I go with online camera shopping? Now, who are you? Are you a particular advertiser? Is that what you're telling me? So an advertiser can definitely run ad on multiple keywords. I can place one single ad copy, make one single ad copy appear for 5 keywords or 10 keywords or whatever. Okay, Guru Prasad says, I think we can get some keywords. We can get some, absolutely, you can make certain changes. Okay, does that answer your question, Parthasarthi? Okay, in case not, you can still ask me. Coming back to the headline stuff, I hope you know this is a headline, guys, which always looks like this. The one on the top with the blue text. Sometimes your top ads look like this, or sometimes your ad on the side can look like this, on the top, the blue one, right? That's a headline, guys, which is of 25 characters always. You cannot go beyond that. You always have to write in this yourself. You can take help from your, I mean, get some idea from your competitors' ads also. That's one, if you are not good with writing. Or else, if you're good with writing, make sure that you're writing some good sense. The words should make sense. And the this is description line one, guys. If you see where my cursor is moving. Excuse me. And the line underneath that is a description line two. Right? Description line one and description line two. 35 characters and again 35 characters. That's the maximum. One thing which I always recommend my participants or my participants absolutely to always use call to action in their description lines. Call to action like the discounts, free shipping, or any particular offer, or you have a new new particular product. Excuse me. Any seasonal sale, something of that sort. Right. That should be offered. And so that's a unique point or a promotional offer, which you can use as a call to action. Call to action means somebody reads that content and makes an action and tries to click on that. Another thing, guys, is a display and a destination URL. Now, the URL which you can see over here, onlinepaidlook.com/Ranjan, Ranjan Gina underscore blog, right? This is a display URL which is always displayed in front of the searcher, right? The person who's using the search engine and gets to see this ad will always get to see the display URL. I hope most of you are aware of what a URL is, the www dot thing of a website. A display URL and a destination URL is different. If the end customer will click on this ad, he or she will not go onto a web page which will have the same URL. The same URL will not open if I would the end customer will click on this. That would be a different URL. There is a common thing between a display and a destination URL, guys, is the domain. This is the domain, right? The major the main domain, which is onlinepaidlook.com. Anything after that, which makes an internal page, you know, anything after that is something which is different in a display and a destination URL. Display and destination URL will always have the same domain, but the end part will always differ. What is the purpose behind showcasing display URL? All right, great question I have. Now, let's say if my web page has a very long URL, okay, Guru Prasad, everybody listen to me. If my web page for which I'm trying to get run my ad is a very long URL, which is, let's say, of 60 characters, Google will never let me submit that across in the display URL, because if it would be 60 characters, it might go beyond this. Absolutely, like Ashish has mentioned. So if it go beyond, and my search results, my search engine page will be way too huge. So that's why Google always restricts our URL. Even if you are, or whenever you are booking a domain, make sure your domain should not be more than 30-35 characters. If your domain goes beyond 40 characters, that can never even fit in the display URL. Even your domain will not fit in. Let me show you with an example, guys. Now I'm, I keep switching over from theoretical to practical. So I hope it's perfectly fine with you. Now, when I type in this keyword, buy iPhone 6, this is a keyword and you can see an ad copy. Okay. Can you see the headline right up here? Just a second. You can see the headline right up there for Amazon, and you can see the display URL, right? The display URL is visible to you, which is pretty simple over here. Even with Apple, you have a small display URL. You will always see display URLs to be very small. Now, have a look what the destination URL looks like. I am clicking on this ad. All right. Have a look on the top. My goodness, can you see what a long, what sort of URL is this, guys? This is huge. The maximum number of characters which can be there with the destination URL is 1024 characters. Always remember 25, 35, 35. 25 being your headline, 35 being your display, description line one, 35 again your description line two, another 35 character, which is your display URL, and your destination URL is 1024 characters. I'm telling you again, what is the green arrow after display URL? Sorry, I couldn't get you. Where is the green arrow? Let me go back. Is it over here? No. Then where exactly are you talking about? Is it over on the over here on the top in the display URL? Okay, that functionality, the green arrow, okay, over there in the search result page you're talking about, that is this particular arrow gives you two options, which is one is cached. Okay, over here the cached version happens, but this one has come in new. So this ad is based on the current search terms. Visit Google Ads settings to learn more. Block specific advertisers or opt out of personalized ads. Okay, now these ad settings have come in. Earlier this was only there for the search ads. Now this, through with the help of this particular, you can go into ad settings and block certain advertiser, and you will never be able to see their advertisements. If I don't want ads to be seen across by, let's say, My Smart Price or by Amazon or any other website, I can go ahead and block that. Right. So 25, 35, 35, 25 being the headline, 35 being the description line one, 35 being again a description line two, display URL being 35 characters, and destination URL, how much, guys? How many characters? Tell me. Yeah, absolutely right, Manu. Absolutely right, Guru Prasad. Can I get to know from everybody? Shashank, absolutely right. So I've got three answers and we are 12 people, so including me, it's 12. So at least 11 of you should answer me. Right. Thanks, Santosh. So, okay, if you are not answering on that part, no problem. Let me try to understand from each one of you. Is everybody clear on the campaign, on the account, AdWord account structure, on the display and destination URL difference, and the character limits which you should have, the relevancy part? Whatever I have covered till now in the past 70 minutes. Is everybody clear? Guru Prasad says yes. Can I get a yes or a no from each one of you? Yes says Shubham. Yes says Shashank. Yes says Sanjeevan. Yes says Ashish. All right. All those who have even joined in new can let me know if something. Santosh, Manu, if any questions, please let me know, guys. Dhruv, Lina, welcome to the session. Partha Sarthi, is everything clear to you? Manu also says yes. All right, great. Partha Sarthi, looking for an answer from you also. Sanjeevan, yes, sounds good, clear. All right, great. Sanjeevan, are you clear? I want to make sure everybody is clear on all the aspects. I can still go ahead and repeat if something is not clear. AdWord, AdSense, all right, great, thanks. So that's the way you can create an ad copy. These are certain parameters. So I'm telling more from the theoretical part. I've already shown you from the practical sense how the display and destination URL differs. All right, this is the same stuff. I go further down. You already know what all things an ad consists of: a headline, a description. These are the description line one and two, the display URL. And when you click on the ad, you go on to the destination URL. Okay. Another example, guys, through which I would like to ask you, what particular advertisement do you think, as per you, is a good ad? So you have ad 1A and 1B. Okay, I'm just going to make it quick for you. And with 1A, you have these 1, 2, and 3 components, which is the headline, the description line, 1 and 2, the destination URL. And then you have another ad, 1B, absolutely right. 1B is a better ad. There are reasons for it. I mean, there are some things being wrong and some things being right. This is more from the general sense, and this is a more specific, all right? It has certain call to actions and it doesn't have any call to action. It is very generic. Absolutely. This is a much better ad copy. Most of you have got that. And I will share these slides, guys, with you. I would upload them on my website and I'll share the links with each one of you and you can go ahead and access them. Right. You can spend some time on that. It's very important that you revise these. Otherwise, it will be all lost. When I'll keep giving you opportunities to attend my furthermore sessions, whenever I'll have new batches coming up, but it makes a lot of sense for making effort from your end also to go ahead and revise them. All right. Similarly, you have 2A and 2B, and I don't want to make you get bored with the same stuff. So 2B is the most appropriate one. All right. So that's with the with the account structure, guys. All right. Now I want to let you know about keyword match types and then add extension, and then we'll do the practical stuff. Now, what exactly keyword match types are? Let's start with an example. If I type in a keyword buy iPhone 6, now who am I? I am a search engine user. Okay, I'm not an advertiser. I'm giving you an example. I'm a search engine user. I type in buy iPhone 6. I press enter. What happens? The Apple ad from the Apple comes in. Absolutely, Dhruv. I'll come on to the exact phrase and all that. The Apple ads come on the top. Then you have the Amazon ad coming on the second one. Now, I have a question for you. In the back end, what sort of keyword for this particular ad copy? Now, this is an ad copy. You all know that, which is a text ad also, or a search ad. So there are three names to it. With this particular ad copy, what Apple would have selected? Would Apple would have selected this particular keyword, guys? Buy iPhone 6, so that whenever someone clicks, types in buy iPhone 6, the Apple's ad should come, whether on the first or on the second. That's not something which I'm asking for. My question is, what keyword would they have selected iPhone 6 in their AdWords? Would they have selected just iPhone, or would they have just connected keyword 6 with their particular ad? She says buy iPhone 6. All right. It can be anything. I'll tell you the major role of keyword. Same keyword you have searched, says Guru Prasad. Great guess. Great answer, Ashish. All right. I would tell you there are settings which an advertiser can do, through which what happens if I, what another thing Apple could have done, Apple could have connected only this particular keyword, iPhone. All right. Only this particular iPhone, if would have been connected, even and would have set on a broad match. There are certain match types. If it would have been a broad match type for anything, it would have got appeared. Let me not confuse you. Let me showcase this with you. Showcase this to you with the help of an example. There are three match types which an advertiser uses. Now, get into the shoes of an advertiser, guys. All right. You guys are advertisers. You have created a account, a Google AdWords account. Underneath a Google AdWords account, you have got certain campaigns. Let's say one of the campaign is, there is campaign one, campaign two, and with underneath campaign one, you have an ad copy, and for ad copy, you have certain keywords. Now, for every keywords, you can define, there are match types to a particular keyword. Absolutely. Yes, you are right, Guru Prasad. Ignore the second one. It's no more there, the broad match modifier. There is one match type which is called broad match. Second is called phrase. And then you have exact as the third one. I'll come on to the negative part also. Broad match, phrase match, exact match. Just try to focus on these three. Then these match types are changed for every keyword by an advertiser. Okay. Why they are used? There is a lot of relevance to it. I mean, you know, if you want to be a good digital marketer, let's say you are going to apply for a job or something, you should know what these match types are and what is the importance behind these. When there is a broad match or a phrase match or an exact match, I'll show with an example. Sorry, I'll move on to this slide. Whenever a keyword is associated to an ad copy, by default, a keyword is set to a broad match only. All right. And with an example, let's say if a particular keyword tennis shoes was being set as a broad match, there is no punctuation. I mean, when I say punctuation, there is no apostrophe or inverted commas or a bracket used for broad match. But for phrase match, if I'll go for phrase match, always these excuse me, inverted commas are used. All right, first of all, I'm telling you that for broad match there are no special characters or no special these symbols used before or after the keywords, but with phrase match these inverted commas are used, and with exact match these brackets are used. Now explaining you what are these three matches. I've told you that with the broad match, nothing before or after the keyword. With phrase match, the inverted commas, I'm repeating again. And with exact match, the bracket. Exact match, the brackets are there. Phrase match, the inverted commas, and broad match, nothing. Let's say by default, if I am, I'm representing an advertiser. You, all of you are an advertiser and you own a sports shop, okay? A sports equipment shop. You're selling tennis shoes, okay? And you have created an ad copy for tennis shoes. Okay, and your anybody who types in a tennis shoe, my ad should appear. That's what you mention across. You connect your ad copy to. When it's on broad match, what will happen if a end audience type in buy tennis shoes? Then also your ad will trigger on the search engine because it's on broad match. What has happened? This was your keyword. Another key phrase. This was your key phrase. And within, before your key phrase, another keyword is being punched across. Then also your ad copy associated to this will trigger. I'm telling you, listen to me carefully. Now, let's say another keyword, best shoes for tennis. What's happening? The word tennis is appearing, which you had selected. The word shoes is appearing, which you had selected. But shoes have come in before and tennis have come in later. And there is a particular word kept in between, and there's a particular word used before. Then also for this keyword also your ad will appear since this is on broad match. Now what happens? Tennis shoes, and then a word after that, a tennis shoes laces, then also your ad will appear if someone will type this ad on the search engine. Okay, got it. We just used in meta tags. All right, great Paathshala. If you've used that, great. Similarly, if you see on the bottom, tennis sneakers, all right, only one word out of these two words have been taken, and anything before or after has been used. Similarly, with running shoes, only one word, which is the second word, have been used, and anything before the shoes word, which is running, have been taken. If somebody types in running shoes, tennis sneakers, tennis shoe laces, best shoes for tennis, buy tennis shoes, all these words are used and in the Google search engine. And on the AdWords account, you have set your keyword as a broad match. You haven't changed the match type. There is a particular place where you can change the match types of your keywords. I'll show you right now. If you make it as a broad, your ad will appear for all these kind of keywords. The overall group research is on which occasion these match can be used, when have big budget, or how it is. Very good question. I'll come on to that. Yeah, absolutely. When you have bigger budget, then you should use them. Let me explain the other two and I'll definitely come on to your question again. Group research, do ask me again once I'm done with these three. Do ask me again. All right. Now have a look at phrase match. What happens with phrase match? I told you that you have the inverted commas before and after these two words. Now your ads will trigger when it's set on phrase match. Your ads will trigger only for these kind of keywords. Red tennis shoes. The overall, now you can see the existence of both the words is needed and in the same sequence. But only thing is, anything after these two words or before these two words needs can be placed so that your ad can trigger. If a particular keyword like shoes for tennis, shoes is coming first and tennis is coming later and four word is used, then your ad will not appear. For phrase, this has to come for sure and in the same sequence, but something before or something after that can come. But the major requirement, eligibility for any keyword, if it's set on phrase match, any keyword which can trigger this ad, which is linked to this keyword, should have these two words in continuation. Anything after or before has to be there. Lena says, buy iPhone 6. What was excuse me, what was the match type used then? I think it was phrase match. Excuse me, we can never know. I asked you, but if I am the end customer, I don't know what keyword phrase type Amazon or Apple would be using in that case. Absolutely. Like Ashi said, it could have been a broad match or anything. It could have been a broad match also. If Amazon would have run it, or let's say a keyword iPhone, then for buy iPhone 6 also it would have appeared. If a phrase match iPhone 6 would have been there, then buy iPhone 6 for, you know, buy iPhone 6 can also, and even for exact also, for any of the three, it's very difficult to judge that since we don't have the panel of their AdWords account. So for tennis shoes, guys, if it's for the phrase match, anything before or after can trigger the ad, but these two have to be there. That's the eligibility. And with the exact match, only and only for tennis shoe, the ad can trigger. If it's only for shoes, somebody types in shoes, note, ad will not appear. If somebody types in tennis, ads will never appear. If somebody types in tennis laces, never ever, ads will never appear. Both these needs to be there in the same sequence, and even after and before, nothing needs to be there. A spelling mistake can definitely be taken. You know, you can see tennis shoes or tennis shoe, that can happen. Had it been a phrase match, you know, if this would have been a phrase match, then red tennis shoe or buy tennis shoe is could have been used. Which keywords types are best, Dhruv? Exact and phrase match are the best in case you're looking for better quality score. But broad matches should be used if you have a huge amount of money. Now, let me tell you the major drawback of using a broad match. Let's say, guys, taking the same example, I'll still ask you again if you have got that. If not, I'll explain it again. Let's say if you are, again, you know, saying the same example, you are the sports equipment seller and you are selling tennis shoes. You have kept this keyword. You want your ad to appear when somebody types in these keywords, but you have kept it on broad. So the end customer, if types in buy tennis shoes or tennis shoe laces also, then also your ad will appear because you have kept it on broad. Let's say you don't sell laces, right? It is going to be unnecessary investment for you. It would be useless, absolutely. Tennis shoes, images, absolutely. If somebody types in tennis shoe images, tennis shoe laces, you know, and even if you, let's say, don't use running shoes, you don't sell running shoes, right? So it doesn't make sense. Is everybody clear on the part on these three major match types, guys? I can suggest you to read more about it. Ashish says yes. Sanjeevan says yes. Pradeep says yes. All right. Thanks, Pradeep, for joining in. All right. Lena says yes. All right. How about others? Sanjeevan, Shashank, Shubham, Dhruv, Pradeep. All right. If in case you guys haven't got that, feel free to ask me again. Or in case you're not able to ask me right now, you can email me or WhatsApp me. I would go ahead and share my details. Most of you know. But still, I'm going to write that across. All right. So I've just done that part. I've shared across my number. You can get in touch with me on WhatsApp, guys. All right, Pradeep. Thanks. So that's with the match types. And let's say what exactly a negative match type does, guys. Let's say if somebody types in free tennis shoes, okay, I run my ads on phrase match, okay, let's say on tennis shoes, somebody types in red tennis shoes or tennis shoes for women. Shubham says, sir, I have to ask that I heard that meta keywords are stopped to use by, okay, that's a SEO question, Shubham. So meta keywords, meta description rather, and meta keywords, these two, are both of them are doesn't really make a lot of difference to the SEO rankings. This is out of the way. Absolutely, I'm coming onto the negative keyword also. To answer your question, Shubham, these are not giving a lot of value, that's for sure. But it doesn't, if you have time with you, I will always recommend you to use enter meta keywords and meta description. They somehow or the other have a slightest effect, even a minute effect. So little drops of water adds to the sea, right? So that's what I would say. If you have time, don't just go ahead and ignore them. Don't ignore them. But that it's on the lower priority. That's what I would say. Okay, so I was saying, if I send it, I hope I have answered your question, Shubham. If I'm running across my ad for the keyword tennis shoes, okay, on the phrase match. Now, if somebody types in tennis shoes for women, will the ad trigger? Now, I have a question for you. My ad is set for this particular keyword, which is set on phrase match. For phrase match tennis shoes, and someone types in a keyword tennis shoes for women. Tennis shoes is appearing for women. Yes, says Ashish. Yes, says Pradeep. Yes, it can trigger. So you have to be sure about that, Guru Prasad. I hope yes, it will trigger. Sanjeevan says yes. All right. Now tell me if now I'm the same sports equipment seller guy. All right. I also keep shoes with me, the tennis shoes, but I don't keep it for women. I don't keep anything for women. I'm a male dominated, a male centric seller. All right. I only serve things to the male. Do you think it's a good investment? You know, if somebody types in tennis shoes for women, my ad appears, that particular lady or guy who has typed that would click on my ad and would go onto my website and see, oh my God, there is no shoes for women. They would go ahead and close my website, and it's going to be a waste of click and waste of money which I've invested onto that click. There is a particular, so I hope it makes sense to you. It's not a worthwhile. So Pradeep says, can you see chat? Absolutely, I'm seeing your chat. Did you answer me something? Guru Prasad says, if she's buying for this, then okay. See, all right. There are a lot of permutation and combination. Okay, I'm Santosh actually. Okay, not really. I wasn't sure. So it says Pradeep. Okay, great. Okay, thanks, Santosh. You can change your name. So I'll otherwise keep calling you Pradeep. No problem. So the answer I wanted to ask from you. So is it a worthwhile investment if I don't keep women's shoes and I'm running this particular keyword, if I'm running my ad for this keyword for phrase match? So it doesn't make sense, right? For this particular thing, guys, there is another functionality given by Google AdWords, which is called a negative keywords. I can place the word women as negative. Where does, Lena says, where does the inverted commas or bracket is typed by user? All right, I'll show you in the ad copies. So when you go into the AdWords campaign, guys, I've already set in a campaign where I would show you how the batch types appear. Can you see the keywords which I have mentioned here? I will go into that part. When I click in the blank space over here, it will show me these match types. Broad match, exact match, phrase match. Can you see that? If I do it exact match, it will automatically, you have the inverted commas. You click on exact match, go ahead and save it. Automatically, these brackets come over. And if I again go ahead and change the second one from the phrase match to the broad match, let's say, automatically they have got disappeared. Right? And if I go ahead and do it again for the phrase match, the inverted commas comes in. Make sense? Is everybody clear on how it looks like? How do you see the match types in the overall panel, guys? All right. Thanks, Pradeep or Santosh. Okay. Thanks, Shashank. Okay. So how to set exact match to all keywords? All right. So if I want to set exact match in one shot to all the keywords, I've got a question. Click on the select all All right. If I want to do it for all the 131, I can select all the 131. All 131 have been selected. Go on to the edit part. Click on change match types. Change match types. So I want to change all the phrase match ones to the exact match ones. All right. She says, sir, can we keep keywords to broad match and set negative keywords? Absolutely. You can do that. But I always say, always have phrase or exact match and then have negative keywords. All right. Okay, now I have all these keywords as exact match. Whenever someone will type in internet marketing course, then only my ad will appear. Okay, right. I hope, Guru Prasad, you got that. So I'm making change again. I want to run them on change match types for exact match to the phrase match. I always prefer a phrase match, guys. Once I'm done that, let me show you how I can place the negative keyword. So if I go further down, I'll keep going down in my ad group AdWords panel. Today I'm running short of time. Otherwise, I would have started right from the beginning. I would want you to, do some R&D on the panel, guys, on the AdWords panel. All right. On the bottom, if you'd see, the negative keywords are appearing. Click on the negative keywords, and I can add negative keywords for my the ad group. I can even do it for the campaign. I can set it on a campaign level or ad group level. So I want to set it on a campaign level, guys. Add keywords, negative keywords. The kind of negative keywords I want to put are free. Okay, since I don't provide these trainings for free, okay, I don't provide them, let's say, any other negative keywords I can think of. So you usually get to know these negative keywords at a later stage. Let's say I want to do it just free as of now. Many people type in free digital marketing training, free, search engine optimization training. Since I don't provide it free, it doesn't make sense for me to, let that happen. Giving you an example. Absolutely right, Ashish. Yeah, exact match, phrase match with negative keywords. You can see I've got phrase match, digital marketing online courses. Okay. If somebody would have typed in free digital marketing online courses, my ad would have triggered. I never want my ad to trigger with free word being used before or after or in between. Since I don't offer free services, that's why, right? Makes sense, guys. So that's with the match types, the keyword match types, whether it's the phrase, exact, broad, and the negative ones. So what is the reason why we use them? I've already shown you. And how do you go ahead and change them in the AdWord platform is over here. Now there are certain another theoretical stuff which I want to talk about today, which we'll implement again. Is the extension, guys. Now there is one thing called ad extensions. Using the same example, buy iPhone 6, the same keyword, which is my favorite keyword. Okay, excuse me. Can you see you have the headline right up here, which is 25, then you have 35, then you have again 35 characters, and you can see 35 characters for the display URL. And if I click on this, the destination URL will come, which would be 1024. But what exactly is these guys? Can you see these two text with a click being there? Ashish says site links. Absolutely. Anybody else? Most of you would be knowing. Shubham, any idea on that? What exactly are these? Manu, Santosh says no. All right. Shubham also, no problem. These are ad extensions. And one of the ad, so they're different kind of, okay, Dhruv, my question was, what exactly are these texts? These texts, so you have the headline, you have the destination URL, display URL showcased here, and when you click, there is a destination URL. You have description line 1, description line 2. And my question was, what exactly are these two text with clickable text? These are called extensions, ad extensions. That's the generic name to it. There are plenty of ad extensions, guys, which are placed with most of the ads, these search ads. All right. Search ads, quite a lot of search ads have ad extensions. With this one, you have two ad extensions. The call buttons also are call extensions. Absolutely right, Shubham. You can see 1, 2, 3, 4. Four clickable text. Over here, you have two clickable text. These are ad extensions, and ad extensions are of many types. Let me use my presentation again. Just a second, guys. All right. Okay, the very first one are site link extensions, which I've already shown you. The ones which I've shown you is one of the kind of ad extensions. So the name for that particular ad extension is a site link. Why this is called a site link extension? Because these particular text are linking to another destination URL. If I click on this, the destination URL will open. All right. You would see. All right. So it's opening in a while. You can see the Apple iPhone page comes up right here. The iPhone 6 page rather. That's the destination URL. And if I click on the world gallery, and then I click on the design button, these are the other internal pages of the website. That's why of the website, you know, internal pages of the websites are placed in these ad extensions. These are called, that's why these are called site link extensions. We will create them. Even creation of these site link extensions have certain, parameters and certain policies. Minimum 2 can be seen. Maximum 4 can be seen the minimum 2, maximum 4, that which is right in front of you, and they always get appeared for the top ads. You would hardly see any ad on the right hand side having site link extension. They never have. Then you have another kind of ad extension, guys, which is called, see, these were the other pages of the site link extensions, world gallery and the design page. There are other pages, guys. There are other extensions like call extensions. The call extension always is created by advertisers to give a facility to the end customer who's typing in a keyword, in a mobile phone and searching for something. With the ad, you will many times see a call button. Now, I'm not showcasing. I'm not running the training on a mobile platform, otherwise I would have shown you. But if you type in a particular keyword in a mobile phone, you would see when you type a keyword, the search ad appears and there is a call button also. There's a call button which most of the time happens, and this is how it appears like. Guru Prasad says review extension, location extension, mobile number. Absolutely right. So mobile number, the call extension I'm taking care of. Review and location, I'm definitely going to come across with. Right, guys? This is a much better picture, which where you can see an advertisement comes up on the mobile browser. And for the end customer using the mobile phone for searching in something gets to see the advertisement like this. We would use and create these call buttons. The idea is whenever the searcher clicks on this, the person using the search engine types the keyword in the mobile search engine, gets this ad, and he or she can actually contact these guys, the North Car Sale guys, call them up with the help of one click. They don't have to go ahead and click on this particular ad and their website will open, and once their website opens, the user will go onto the contact us page, see what is the overall what is the overall number, and then go ahead and start typing. It's just one click away, guys, right? We will create that. So this is one second extension. Then you have a third extension, which you can see is called a location extension. No problem, Guru Prasad. I know the app extension. I know you're getting excited, which is okay. The number three extension, guys, is called a location extension. So number one was site link. Number two is call extension. We can also place a location extension with the help of these add extension functionality. We always have an add extension functionality, which we'll create. More of theoretical today, but would be less of theoretical and more of practical next time. Next time, we'll create search ads by using these match types and using these all location settings and these add extensions also. So number three is add, number third add extension, guys, is the particular location extension. What happens instead of clicking on the call button, if the end customer clicks on this, he or she would be taken across to the Google Map app, and within the Google Map app, the end customer who is using that mobile phone would get to see how far this particular place, North Car Sales, is there from the location where he or she is accessing the mobile phone. If I am standing right now, if I am in, let's say, a Connaught Place, New Delhi, and I type in, restaurants in South Extension, and I get to see one of the restaurants in South Ex, New Delhi, has got an ad. They have a call extension. I can call them up straight away, call them and ask them, can you book a table for me? They say yes. I go ahead and disconnect the call, and then I ask them how to get, and then I want to know how to visit their place. I can use the GPS. I can use the same, what do you say, map extension button. Click on that, and my GPS will open automatically on my phone and will direct me that it's 40 minutes away. It's going to take that much time. Right. I hope most of you have used GPS. The map functionality, call button is clear to you. Similarly, you have an app extension. I would show you probably app extension generally works. Let's say if I do book my show. Global positioning system. Absolutely. I don't have so these are site link extensions right up here. Excuse me, guys. Okay, let me see if I can show you an app extension. No, even not, that's not there. Okay, let me show you with the help of a particular image only. App extensions majorly also appear for the mobile platform only, guys. If somebody is typing in a particular keyword in a mobile phone, similar to what do you say, a call extension and a location extension, an app extension also comes in where the end customer is being asked that not to just go ahead and click on our ad, but you also have an option of getting the app for us. You can see this is how the search browser looks like for a mobile phone. Somebody has typed in Amazon. Right, Manu, you can surely have the recorded version of the session at a later stage. I can provide you that. Manu, can you just help me with your phone number in the private chat? I would, or you can just ping me on WhatsApp. So, guys who have joined in for the first time, Manu, Sanjeevan, and yeah, I believe a couple of you. Right, so if you can just ping me on WhatsApp, that'll be great. And I can surely help you with whatever questions you'll have. So, all right. So the Amazon can has actually got their all right, thanks, Manu. So what I was saying, Amazon has got their app extension right up there. So because they're promoting across their advertise their app with the help of these ads. They're letting the end customer know that you just don't need to search on our website. You can also search on things even on their app. Right, guys, I hope it's not getting boring for you. The last just 10 more minutes and then we'll wrap up the session. Probably you guys might be feeling hungry or something. All right. Okay, no, says Ashish. All right. Are there any additional changes? Are there additional charges for these? Very great question. Are there additional charges for these ad extensions? Ask Shashank. There are no additional charges. The way you pay per click on per click basis, just give me a moment, guys. Give me a moment.
Yeah, I'm back. Sorry, I said just a couple of minutes, I'm going to be back. So, all right. So, okay. So the question which you have asked me, are there any extra charges for this? There are no extra charges for showcasing them again. The way you showcase your ads, the way similarly, you can showcase your ad extensions to the end customer whenever the a particular keyword for which you have attached triggers that. All right. But if the particular customer clicks on any of your extension, whether it's a call or a location or a site link or a mobile, so I have told you about four extensions, the same per click cost gets deducted. If your end customer has clicked on your ad also and on your mobile app extension also, on your call extension, on your location extension also, all of these extensions, so you will get charged for all of them. Once it you will get charged for the very first time when your ad has got a click, there's a click on your ad, that is number one charge. Number two, when the mobile app extension is being clicked, if the end customer only clicks on your mobile app extension and doesn't click on the ad, then you're charged only once. So similarly, I mean, it's per click basis, guys. I hope it's clear. So the way I clicked on couple of site link extensions for Apple website, so they have got they would have got charged like two clicks, right? The one, number one, okay, I clicked on three, the main ad, the second one was the one of the ad site link extension, and the third was again a site link extension. So three clicks were being made. All right, so that's with the what do you say, mobile app extension. And then you have a review extension also, guys. There are certain reviews where people actually, I'll show you how that looks like again. Again, I can show you an image only because very few people use the review extension. Let me show you that. Sometimes the Google pages, the Google Plus pages have got the reviews. I hope most of you know that you can write in and give Google Plus reviews on a particular business Google Plus page. Right, so you as an advertiser, if you have got good great reviews, you can go ahead and showcase that for your Google Plus page. Over here you can show that out of five you have got 4.7 star or whatnot, right? Similarly, you can have even connect your other review sites also. That's with review extension. What all extensions are there? Let me just recall. So this is with the site link, I've already told you. So you can add up to four site link extensions and 35. So there are these extension guys always help in much achieving much better CTR. Product extension, these are no more there. Phone extension, I've already told you. Location extensions, I've already told you. Location and phone again. I also want to know about two terms, CPA, cost per acquisition, and CPC. Please let me know when it can be discussed. This class, no, this one I'll let you know. So, okay, used everything at once. Geography and PPC, I've already told you. So all these extensions I've cleared. And I've got a question right now. Okay, so that was about the extension, guys. All right, so I've got a question right now. What is the difference between CPA and CPC? Let me know what exactly you mean by CPC first. I'm not going to ask you for CPA, Lena, because CPC is a very easy term. Whether it's a PPC or a CPC, guys, it means the same thing, pay-per-click or cost-per-click. The amount of money which I'm paying for every ad, every click, the amount of money, which whether it's 50 rupees, that's CPC. Now, let's say if I do an iPhone 6, I run the same thing. I take the same example, all right? I am trying to tell you about this cost per acquisition. What exactly is an acquisition, guys? There is one thing called an acquisition or a conversion. Business, absolutely. The conversion can be measured for an e-commerce site as a, what do you say, a sale, all right? An e-commerce site will always consider an acquisition or a sale. A sale is actually counted by an e-commerce site either as a sale or a conversion, all right? For a non-e-commerce website, a conversion would be counted as either as a sign-up. Sorry, I'm typing in the wrong window. So a conversion for an non-e-commerce site can be either a sign-up, all right? What do you say? An inquiry, absolutely. A lead form, a lead with the form fill-up, all right? That can be a conversion. Or another conversion for a non-e-commerce site can be, let's say, a download of a software, all right? Or maybe download of a ebook, all right? These kind of things. Absolutely, Shashank said that. App, absolutely, Lena. So somebody downloading an app, somebody downloading an ebook, somebody downloading a software, filling up a form, that's for a non-e-commerce based website. Let's say I have run a campaign, all right, where I type in a particular keyword, digital marketing training. Digital marketing training, let's say I'm based out of Delhi NCR. Let's say if I do a digital marketing training in Ghaziabad, I type in this keyword, all right? Now you can see, now I'm right up here for, for SEO, but I'm not right up here for the paid ad. Now what these guys have done, you have DSIM or Digi Perform or Digital Marketing School. If I will click on these guys' ad, all right, these people will be looking for conversions with the help of a form submission. If I'll go ahead and submit in their form, it's a conversion for them. If it's not, then it's not a conversion. If 10 clicks similarly to mine, you know, there are 10 people who are typing in similar kind of keywords, and 10 clicks happen. Out of 10 clicks, only 2 people submit across their details. For 10 clicks, they are getting 2 conversions. And every click, let's say, was for, just a sec. Every click, let's say, was for 10 rupees, all right? So 10 rupees per click into total 10 clicks which have happened, which leads to 100 rupees. I've spent 100 rupees because 10 clicks and 10 rupee was the cost for one of the click. And out of 400 rupees, I've got just 2 form submission, which means my CPA will come to rupees. How much? 50 rupees. 50 rupees would be my one conversion cost. Make sense? That's the CPA. And if I talk about my CPC, CPC in my this case is 10. Only, which I've already told you, I have been paying 10 rupees for one click, but now I have been paying 10 rupees per click. And after 10 clicks, which have happened, only 2 people submitted the form. 10 clicks happened, 2 people submitted the form, which means two conversions happened, which is 2 acquisitions happened. 100 rupees, absolutely, CPA is equal to total cost upon the number of acquisition. You got that right. Make sense, guys? Now it's 10:25. I don't want to make you keep you waiting. I have covered everything in the theoretical way for the search ads. In case you want to, I'll share the recorded version of this video of this session. Go ahead and use the same stuff again to revise it. In case you still have more time, I have got furthermore videos where I have covered in the practical way also. So you want to go ahead, view that and start working on your AdWords account also. Create a campaign, create a ad copy and then ad groups and ad copies and just link ads to it. Use the keyword match types, start creating the ad extensions also. the best way to get access to my, what do you say, videos is to go onto YouTube and type in Digital Marketing Paathshala. All right, so in case I forget, sure, you can, I mean, you guys can ask me questions on WhatsApp, on email or whatever, but I'm letting you know that's what you should do. Go on to YouTube, guys, and just type in Digital Marketing Paathshala. You can see 78 videos right up here. Click on that. And in case if I forget to send you the link, you can see, once you go into my channel, you can see the playlist. All right. Within the playlist, you have, yours is a Monday batch, so I'll be uploading the video right up here, the latest video. Then you already, I have got a Sunday batch, which is running parallelly. You can check videos in the Sunday batch version also. So you can refer to the playlist section and have a look at the videos in the Sunday and the Monday batch. Make sense, guys? Are we all good? Any further questions? I know most of you are connected with me on WhatsApp and also on email. Whosoever has joined in for the first time can just let me know. Can take down my number. I'll share my number and my email ID again. Feel free to get in touch with me. I'll help you in whatever way I can. Absolutely. So Santosh, I'll get that for you tomorrow. It was a bit hectic for me this week. I'll get that done, and I'm sharing. So I've shared my credentials, guys, my email address and my phone number, in case you have further questions, and we'll connect then. Absolutely, Santosh. I'll surely share it tomorrow for sure. That's a perfect yes. All right. So are we all good? Are there any further questions, guys? Let me know. I'll help you. We still have a couple of more minutes. It's 10:28, and then we'll wrap up. All right. I don't think so. So nobody's saying something. I think everybody's feeling sleepy. Okay. Can you share today's the PPT link? All right. So the PPT is. All right. So I'll share the PPT link with each and everyone. Okay. So when is the next class going to be? I'll keep you updated, guys, on your WhatsApp. So I hope everybody is connected with me on WhatsApp. Whenever there's going to be a next class, I'll let you know through WhatsApp. Most probably it's going to be on Sunday, and then we'll have on Monday. I'm soon going to start with Friday, probably, but not really soon, maybe after 3 weeks or so. All right. Thank you so much. I hope it was a valuable session where you got some information which was not known to you earlier on. And we'll go ahead and do the practical stuff also. All right. Great. Everybody, thank you so much. So Jeevan, you can let me know. You have my number. You can take down my number in case you want to speak to me. All right. Take care, guys. Good night. Bye now. Take care. Enjoy. Bye.